Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the block diagram of NTSC encoder, its functionality and its operation. So let's begin with the topic. NTSC basically stands for National Television System Companies. The NTSC standard was developed by the American companies. In case of NTSC, the luminance signal is represented by an alternating current and having a fixed value of frequency that is nothing but 3.5794545 megahertz. So this value is precisely defined in the NTSC standard. The reason for defining precise value is nothing but the accurate recovery of the signal at the receiver. So as the value is defined precisely, it is possible to accurately and precisely recover the signal at the receiver. Now, in case of NTSC standard, the NTSC standard provides proper video or proper operation when it is used in the closed circuit environment, but it provides a change in color problem when it is used in the broadcasting environment. Now, NTSC standard comes into the picture because to fulfill or to meet the requirement of the television standard. In earlier development of the television standard, the black and white televisions ill to ground and the technical standards which was used in the earlier days was not able to fulfill the requirements of the color television system. So at that time, the broadcasting companies which was present in the America uses a wide range of encoding methods, but these methods having some conflict with each other. So in order to reduce that conflict or in order to overcome that conflict and to provide a common standard that can be used worldwide, the NTSC standard comes into the picture. So basically the NTSC standard uses a frequency of 60 Hz. Therefore it provides or it uses 30 frames per second. Each frame consists of 525 lines in each field. So in case of NTSC, it provides many advantages. That means it provides low cost, it provides easy video mixing, then it provides high frame rate because of which the flicker is get reduced. Also it provides high signal to noise ratio. So these are the some advantages provided by NTSC system. Now let's move to the encoder, that means the transmitter of the NTSC system. So let's have a look of the block diagram of NTSC encoder. So in the block diagram, we will come to know that the three signals are received as an input signal, that is RGB to the matrix. So by using a suitable matrix, the three input signal, that is RGB, gets converted into a I and Q signal. After matrix, filter, balance modulator, adder and main transmitters are present. Now let's understand the working and description of block diagram in detail. So a suitable matrix is used to generate I and Q signal directly from the three camera output. Now the I signal is given as 0.60R minus 0.28G minus 0.32B. And the green and blue camera outputs are inverted before feeding it to the matrix. Similarly, the Q signal is generated and the Q signal having value 0.21R minus 0.52G plus 0.31B. Now here the inverter is placed at the output of the green camera before mixing it with the other two camera component. So in this way the I and Q components are get obtained. Now the bandwidth of I and Q component are restricted before applying them it to the balance modulator. Now let's back to the figure of NTSC encoder. So in the figure, before balance modulator, a 0.5 MHz filter and 0 to 1.5 MHz filter is present, and that filter is basically used for restricting the frequency of I and Q signal respectively. So Q signal in case of NTSC encoder, the Q signal is frequency restricted by using a filter of 0 to 0.5 MHz, and I signal is restricted by using a filter having frequency of 0 to 1.5 MHz. After this restriction, the frequencies and or the signals are get further transmitted to the balance modulator. Each balance modulator or each signal having the separate balance modulator. The balance modulator, that therefore here two balance modulator is present. One is for I signal and another is for Q signal. Now in the diagram, color subcarrier generator block is present, and that block is used for generating the subcarrier color signal. The subcarrier color signal having a fixed value of frequency, and that is nothing but 3.579545 megahertz. This fixed value provides, that means the value is precisely defined by the generator. Because of this precise value, there will be a compatibility between the monochrome and color television system. And also, other reason is it is easily possible to recover the signal at the receiver very accurately. So basically, the color subcarrier generator provides the color subcarrier frequency. That frequency is get phase shifted by 57 degree in clockwise direction, and again it is get phase shifted by 90 degree before applying it to the balance modulator. So because of that, in case of I and Q, there will be a phase shift of 90 degree between I and Q signal. Now, if there is any interference between the luminance signal and high frequency video signal, then that signal or that interference, it gets suppressed by using the subcarrier of the color. So that for that purpose, the color subcarrier is required in the NTSC encoder. Now moving back to the description part, now let's see what is the function of balance modulator. So the balance modulator having a characteristics that it suppresses the carrier and provides frequency translation. That means the I and Q balance modulators are basically used for providing suppression in order to avoid any interference between the carrier signal and the noise signal and to provide a frequency translation process. Both amplitude and phase of its output are directly related to the instantaneous amplitude and phase of the modulating signal. Now, the subcarrier phase angle shifted to the location of I and Q. After frequency translation, the subcarrier angle phase angle again shifted towards I and Q. The output from both the modulators retain full to identify modulating color difference between the signals. The sideband restricted output from I modulator combines with the output of Q modulator by using a adder or by using a mixer circuit, and it forms a monochrome signal. Then it is combined with the bias signal. Now let's move back to the diagram so that we can have the clear idea. So now in the diagram, after balance modulator, the signals are get combined with the help of adder by using a bandpass filter. The bandpass filter is used for the I signal. The Q signal is directly get added with the I signal. Now, in case of NTSC encoder, at the adder, we received three different input. One is nothing but the chrominance signal, which is a mixture or addition of I and Q signal. And other signal is nothing but a composite Y signal, which is obtained directly from the adder, that is from the matrix. So the output of the adder is now given to the main transmitter, which also having a sound signal as a second input. Now the signal is further transmitted by using a transmitter antenna. So in this way, basically the NTSC encoder work. So now moving back to the description part, here the color subcarrier has the same frequency of 3.579545 megahertz for all the station, whereas the assigned picture carrier frequency is different for each channel. So this is how the NTSC encoder works. So in summarize, let's move back to the diagram and have a summary of the NTSC encoder. So in case of NTSC encoder, the three signals from the camera is provided to the suitable matrix, and the three input signals are nothing but red, green and blue. The matrix provides two signals, that is nothing but I and Q signal, which are further frequency restricted by using a filter. For I signal, the filter of 0 to 1.5 MHz is used, and for Q signal, the filter of 0 to 0.5 MHz is used. Again, the signals are provided to the balance modulator so that the frequency translation or suppression of the subcarrier takes place. The carrier subcarrier generator or the color subcarrier generator is basically used for providing the color subcarrier frequency having a value which is same as the value of color subcarrier, that is 3.5 MHz. So because of this value, there will be a compatibility between the monochrome and color system. So the color subcarrier is get frequency shifted, or we can say the color subcarrier is get phase shifted by 57 degree in clockwise direction and 90 degree, so that there will be a phase difference between the I and Q signal. Further, the I and Q signal are given to the adder. Now the I signal, before applying it to the adder, again get frequency restricted by using a bandpass filter. Now the output of the bandpass filter and output of the Q balance modulator forms a signal that is called as chrominance signal C. The chrominance signal along with the composite Y signal is given as the input to the adder along with the burst gate, which are used for providing the color burst. So all these signals get mixed together by using the adder network and provided to the main transmitter circuit. The main transmitter circuit having another input, which is nothing but the sound signal. So with the help of sound signal and the inputs received from the adder, that is nothing but the composite chrominance signal, the signal is get transmitted. Now, in this case, the sync and blanking pulses are given to the adder at the input side so that the signal is get mixed with the luminance signal, that is nothing but the Y signal, which is also generated by using a matrix. So, in this way, the NTSC encoder works. So, I hope you understand the working and block diagram of NTSC encoder. So, thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.